Support for Kalamazoo Lively Arts is provided by the Irving S. Gilmore Foundation, helping to build and enrich the cultural life of Greater Kalamazoo.
Good evening and welcome to Kalamazoo Lively Arts. I'm John Koch. Each week on Kalamazoo Lively Arts, we'll showcase those with a passion for the arts. Often we go behind the scenes, sharing with you the challenges for those who strive to be creative. We hope you'll meet individuals that inspire as well as entertain. We know that you will find them interesting. Coming up tonight, it all began in Kalamazoo for a girl band who hit the top of the charts in the 1960s and toured with Dick Clark. Velvelettes got their start in Kalamazoo. After breaking up and going their separate ways to marry and raise families, the women are together again and singing for audiences across the country. Jan Cruzy has more about this remarkable story.
The Velvelettes, a girl band as they were called in the 60s, that made the top of the charts with the hit Needle in a Haystack. They rubbed elbows with such famous Motown recording artists as Smokey Robinson, The Temptations, and Martha Reeves and the Vandellas. What a lot of people may not realize is that this group had its beginnings in Davis Hall on the campus of Western Michigan University. Bertha McNeil was a music major at WMU, and while displaying her musical talents on the keyboard, someone suggested that she start a singing group. So she and her friend Mildred Gill and Mildred's little sister Carolyn, or Cal, along with Bertha's cousin Norma, entered a talent show and won $25. Cal was the baby of the group, only a ninth grader.
When my sister approached me about going to Western to audition for this group with a lady that she had met up there. I didn't hesitate. It was like right up my alley.
They were encouraged to travel to Detroit to audition for Hitsville, USA, now known as Motown Records.
When we started the group, we didn't really think of recording at that time. We just really wanted to, you know, just really sing for fun.
When they arrived at the record company one cold, snowy Saturday, the receptionist was icy.
You know, she was chewing her gum and sort of like, well, I'm sorry, we don't have auditions on Saturdays. And she even asked us, you know, where are you from? We said Kalamazoo, and she goes, Kalamahoo? You know, that kind of, so it was like, oh, you know, this devastation. So we actually were in tears.
As luck would have it, a studio producer intervened and let them audition. A record contract soon followed, and the girls were on their way.
There He Goes was the first song that we made, which my cousin Norma wrote that song. When the exciting part is when you hear your record on the radio for the first time, that is a thrill beyond compare. I don't know if you feel famous, but you just feel very, it really lifts your esteem. I mean, you feel this group that we started did Western just for fun, and now people really want to hear us sing. You begin to say, well, wow, this is pretty cool, you know?
The Velvelettes quickly rose to stardom, appearing on American Bandstand and then touring with Dick Clark to cities like Baltimore, Chicago, Washington, D.C., and even the Apollo Theater in New York. During one of those tours, Cal roomed with Diana Ross.
Well, she sacrificed. She sacrificed her personal life for a career at an early age, an early on, where we didn't necessarily do that. See, we had more to do with our lives. Diana Ross was totally consumed with becoming a star, a celebrity. The Velvelettes had other priorities. Our parents made it known to Berry Gordy that they didn't want him interfering with our education.
While still at the top of the charts, the Velvelettes called it quits, leaving their fans wondering why.
You know, and a lot of people ask us that, and you know what? We ask ourselves that. You don't quit Motown. But I think, like I said, the love bug had hit us, and we did want to have kids, and we're very much And this gives me great pride to say this. We're very much family-oriented, our group. If I could say this, our folks are still together, moms and dads of every one of us. We're very proud of that. And so we're brought up in a very strong family atmosphere. So when we did quit to have our families and this kind of thing, it was like, this is something that we're just in our hearts to do.
Mildred and Norma stayed in the Flint area. Cal traveled to the West Coast and then came back to Kalamazoo to raise her son. Bertha was a successful mother and music teacher. But the yearning to perform again was never far, and Bertha decided to get the group back together, 15 years after their last performance.
We got to do this again. I meant that thrill again of making people feel good with what you do, that what you like to do. That is one of the greatest feelings in the world. And we said, let's go back and do it. And that's how we got back together for the second time.
The Velvelettes are back, and both agree it's better the second time around.
And I think as long as people love Motown music, they'll always be Velvelettes. I think that's the key. And I think people appreciate the fact that we stayed together all these years. It's called commitment, and that is a something that I think is a lesson to be learned for everybody out there. The commitment and the friendship that we have through it all, and just stayed in there.
The group was recently portrayed on the NBC show American Dream, a recreated American Bandstand. Tyra Banks played Cal.
So she chose that song and chose to portray us based on, a selection of girl groups that they put before her.
Bertha and Cal say a highlight of their career was receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award last year in California.
That was very special because anytime you're presented a Lifetime Achievement Award for what you do, it's very, very touching. And Berry Gordy was in the audience. We have a very nice picture that was taken with him. So that kind of stands out.
There was also a girl group reunion at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland and an appearance on a Motown special on PBS earlier this year. The Velvelettes, a star singing group in the 60s, still wowing them 45 years later.
We still dream. I think that's important too. To always have dreams. There's no such thing as, an age thing when it comes to dreams. We said we're gonna sing till we drop.
All right. Well, I once believed.
Doodle-lang, doodle-lang.
Oh, fellas were nice.
Doodle-lang, doodle-lang.
The girls listen to me.
Doodle-lang, doodle-lang.
Take my advice.
Doodle-lang, doodle-lang.
Girls, you better get yourself on the right track. Cause finding a good man, girl,
is like finding a needle in a haystack.
What I say, girls?
Needle in a haystack. Yeah, yeah, shoo-doo.
The Velvelettes still making music after more than 40 years of singing their first song together. From all of us at Kalamazoo Lively Arts, thank you for being with us tonight. I'm John Koch, hoping you take time this week to enjoy the lively arts of Kalamazoo.
Support for Kalamazoo Lively Arts is provided by the Irving S. Gilmore Foundation, helping to build and enrich the cultural life of Greater Kalamazoo.